Dern. Oh, you sound very happy. So we eventually made it to Glasgow Pride. I hope we don't let you down. Are you ready? Oh, fuck off, Glasgow. Are you ready?
And you're the sun that shines on me.
First off, yeah. And you know, playing Pride for us is a big deal, especially myself, as I've been told about a million times, once a hairdresser, always a hairdresser. Okay, you ready for a bit more music?
Yeah.
Here we go.
I'm not the only one.
having a good look out here. You look pretty young. Either that or I'm a lot older than I think and my eyes are really fucked. I love you too. Okay. I don't know, some of you are definitely not old enough to remember this far back. You know. Yeah, you. I love the way you just did that with your hair. Very attractive, darling. And now you have on your Stetson. Okay, so this is where we started. And we released our first single in 1989. Do you remember that far back? Well, you bloody do. Been given the finger at a show, mate. I love it. His boyfriend's going like that. He fucking never gave you the finger. That's because you know I would fucking fly off the stage. I knew it was a friendly finger. Has anybody ever had a friendly finger? Michael Barrister loves a friendly finger. Okay, so this is where it all started. Right, I want to see all your hands in the air. Oh my God, you're the most obedient audience I've ever had. Are you ready? Here we go, this is the cow punk style. I just need a friend. Okay. If there's one place that I can tell this story, this has got to be where it is. Because it involves the high priestess of priestesses of gay icons. Plus, I knocked her off number one year, which I'm quite proud of. Okay, so the story goes like this. We went off to America, to Atlanta, Georgia, to work with a man called Dallas Austin, right? Oh, for fuck's sake, you lot should know who Dallas Austin is. Don't go chasing waterfalls. Please stick to the rivers and the rings that you used to. I know that you're gonna have it your way or nothing at all. I think you're moving too fast. Yeah. Okay. Dallas Austin wrote that song, okay? So we were going off to Atlanta to work with this man. And we'd been talking on the phone loads. And of course, I did what any good Glaswegian would do. I put on my posh telephone voice when I was talking to him. Basically, so as he would understand me. So we're all very excited about this. And the night before we're leaving to go to America, I went to a party in London, as you do. And I ran into your lady herself, Madonna. Fuck about. So we're having a conversation and she says, what you up to? I says, oh, I'm going off to America tomorrow morning to work with Dallas Austin. Now Madonna did the Bedtime Stories album with Dallas. And she says to me, ah, he's always late. Don't take any bullshit, really bust his balls, right? So I thought, okay, if Madge says don't take any shit, then I ain't taking any shit. So we arrive in Atlanta, we get to the studio, everybody's there and everything's going on. And we get there and no Dallas. We wait an hour, no Dallas. 2 hours, no Dallas. I think, fuck the shit. I'm out of here. So we say to the engineers, we're going back to the hotel. Give us a call when he gets here and we'll come to the studio because I ain't waiting on him any longer. So go back to the hotel. A couple of hours later, the phone goes. And it's the engineer. He says, oh, Dallas is on his way. I went, fucking whoopee-doo. Give us a call when he's standing in front of you. Then I will leave the hotel and then I will come to the studio. So we get a phone call. We walk in. Now remember, we've only spoke on the phone, so we've built this friendship up over the phone. So by the time I get to the studio, it's like 6 hours I've been waiting, and I am pissed. And seriously, I'm really pissed off. I'm not happy at all. Walk in and Dallas is like, hey baby! I was like, oh, fucking baby me, son. So basically, I went to a bit of a rant. And that was all good and fine. We ended up being very, very good friends, and we're still friends now. But we went for a dinner a few years later, and Dallas said to me, he says, do you remember when we first met? I was like, oh, yeah. How could I forget? He says, you know what? I've always wanted to ask you, and it's taken me up until now to actually get the balls to ask you the question, but what were you actually saying to me that day? Is that we ended up writing this song together, and it's such a beautiful love song. And after our big outlet of my vocabulary of swearing, this is where we got to. This is In Demand. Yeah.